मैसेप डॉक्टर पुष्पा कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ होम्योपैथी फार्मेसी, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथी साइंस एट द ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. टूडे द टॉपिक इज एक्शन ऑफ ड्रग्स. लेट्स बिगिन ऑन द टॉपिक. द एक्शन ऑफ ड्रग ऑन द ह्यूमन बॉडी इज कॉल्ड द फार्माकोडायनामिक्स, एंड वॉट द बॉडी डज विद द ड्रग्स इज कॉल्ड फार्माकोकाइनेटिक्स. Means the action of the drug in on the human body is called the pharmacodynamics, and body work on the drug and counteraction of the body on the drug is known as the pharmacokinetics. The drugs that enter the human tend to stimulate certain receptor ion channels, acts on the enzymes or transporter protein. As a result, they cause the human body to react in a specific way. There are the two types of drugs, agonist or antagonist. Agonist drug means to stimulate and activate the receptors of the human body. Antagonist means that they stop the agonist from the stimulating the receptor. Once the receptor are activated, either triggered or a particular response directly on the body, or they triggered the release of hormones or other endogenous drugs in the body to stimulate a particular response. Master Hanemann described two types of action in the drug: primary action or secondary action. It is given in aphorism 63 or 64 of Organon of Medicine. Primary action of the drug. In aphorism 63 of Organon, describe the every agent that acts upon the vitality, every medicine derange more or less the vital force and cause a certain alteration in the health or individual for a longer or shorter period. This term is primary action. Secondary action known as a dynamic action of drug. It is automatic action or our vital force in the reaction of primary action. Or secondary action is a reaction of the vital force to the primary action. The secondary or dynamic action produce a certain physical or mental symptom which depend upon the mutual relation between the specific property or drug and the individual susceptibility. In homeopathy, the drug action is the sum total of action imparted on the individual living human being and the sum total of the reaction that it can induce induced by the vital force of the same time. Secondary action may be two types, that is secondary counteraction or secondary curative action. When the action of drug is exhausted, the vital force arouses itself and develops the exactly opposite condition of the primary action. That is known as a counteraction. In condition where the exactly opposite state does not exist or not possible, the vital force strive or utilize in superior power to extinguish the changes brought about by the primary action of the drug, thereby restore health. This secondary action of the vital force is curative action. The curative action depend upon the principle of similis grunter, where the secondary counteraction depends upon the principle of contraria. The following various facts are observed regarding the drug action in relation to their specificity: administration to healthy human being, drug administration to excessively large doses produce certain symptoms during the initial stage of that drug action, which are followed later by the symptoms exactly opposite to them. The first series of symptoms are due to the primary action of the drug on the organ. Musculator series of the symptom are secondary action, that is the reaction of the vital force. Drug administration in moderate dose rarely exhibit the secondary action. They are only produce the primary action. However, the expectations are seen in case of narcotic drugs. In moderate dose, narcotic drugs produce the secondary action because in their primary action, the narcotic take away insensibility, susceptibility and irritability of the healthy organism. Due to their peculiar action of the central nervous system, under certain conditions, some drugs when administration in moderate doses produce symptoms exactly opposite to those produced during primary action. These are not due to the secondary action but represent the alternating state of the various paroxysms of the primary action and known as the alternating action. Drug administration in infinitesimal doses, they produce the secondary curative action, the vital force react only in such magnitude as is required to raise the healthy health again to previous healthy state. Only exception is seen idiosyncratic person. Idiosyncratic person are abnormally susceptible to medicines, where agonizing secondary action are seen. The secondary action of the drug is curative in nature and proportional to their primary action, where the living organism reacts from these only such a magnitude as is required to raise the healthy again to previous healthy state. The original when provided to the principle of homeopathy are followed. Idiosyncratic. It is in given in aphorism 117. Peculiar corporeal constitution which although otherwise healthy is brought into the more or less morbid state by substance which seems to produce no impression or chances in others. Hope you all understand the drug action and namaste. Thank you.